you know this team well. So when you think about these 300 wins, are they more about Belichick or Brady in your mind?
For me, I have to say it's about the players. Yeah, so I have to say it's about Brady. I could have the greatest coach in the world. If I don't have a player that can go out there with the talent and execute it, then it can't get done. So, you know, it's sort of a six in one hand, half a dozen in the other. But when it comes down to it, that caliber of player, you know, the caliber of players, you know, through his career, you know, he even said himself, you know, the players that he's had good players, great players. And those have contributed to those 300 wins. He hasn't went out there and played a down a ball to do that. Of course, I have seen players and teams win in spite of coaching. But the other way is done way more often than vice versa. Yeah.
So Shannon Sharpe, a guy who played defense for Bill Belichick at the end of his career, is saying, I'm going to give the edge to Tom Brady.
Okay, but I'm not going to do that. I didn't play one down in New England. I've never set foot in New England except to put foots in New England because I won a lot of time, a lot of games there.
Was Tom Brady there?
Yeah, I beat him. I beat him in 02.
Did you?
Yeah, the year after they won the Super Bowl, we beat him. The Denver Broncos with Brian Greasy went in there and beat the brakes off him. Yeah, run 10. Look it up.
That disqualifies Tom Brady from the Hall of Fame. I don't think he belongs now.
That's what I was saying. See, there you go.
2002.
Yeah, look it up. I'm going to take Coach Belichick because Coach Belichick has so much on his plate. He has to worry about the offense. I got to get what Tom needs for offense. I got to worry about the defense. I got to worry about special team. And the one thing that he's done a better job of than most coaches ever do is turning over his coaching staff. Ooh, it's hot. Turning over his coaching staff. Bill O'Brien is somewhere else. These guys leave, and for the most part, they don't even get an opportunity. Romeo Cornell is somewhere. Charlie Weiss didn't get an opportunity to come. The only guy that's left there from a coaching standpoint, Skip, and come back has been Josh McDaniels. None of the other coaches leave and come back. And you look at what he does with. Jamie Collins is in the running for Defensive Player of the Year. He got cut from Cleveland. Kyle Van Noy, he got cut from Detroit. Chung, he got cut from Philly. Jason McCarty, he takes these guys and these guys playing at all pros. They're playing at Defensive Player of the Year type levels. That's what he does. And he does it year, it doesn't matter. Because I saw him in 2008 when Tom got injured. He took Matt Castle. Ice Cream Castle, and win 10 games. I saw when Tom Brady was suspended in 2014 for the first four games, I saw him win three of those four games with Jacoby Brissett and Jimmy Garoppolo. That's what he did.
Jimmy Garoppolo is undefeated right now.
Jacoby's really good.
That's why he wanted to move on. By the way, he knew he was a good player.
Matt Castle went on to Kansas City and made the Pro Bowl. Wow.
Yeah.
That's pretty good.
A guy that was a guy that didn't start one game in college. He played behind Carson Palmer and Matt Leinart.
Is there any shame in that?
Coach Belichick says, you know what? I see something in you. The very same thing he saw in Tom Brady. I see something in that guy. That guy that couldn't beat out Brian Greasy. But I don't know. We're not talking about that. We're talking about NFL. Coach Belichick gets 75%. Tom Brady gets 25%.
25? You can't even go 50-50?
Nope.
How you don't go 50-50?
Easy. Because he's doing all the shopping. He's doing all the cooking.
If he go in there and he puts me at quarterback, we can go ahead and get this done because he's such a great coach?
You at quarterback right now, they 6-1. You at quarterback right now, 6-1.
I can't even give myself credit
for that. 6-1 with that.
No way.
You saw that defense.
The defense would have actually had to win six of those games for me.
Right now, if Tom Brady just took the ball and threw it in the ground, they'd be 3-1. If he just take the ball and throw it in the ground, don't he do nothing?
They're not 7-0.
Hold on, think about that. Let that sink in for a second.
I understand.
If
what
the
you're
quarterback
saying.
Just takes the ball and punt it every time he get it. They 3-1 right now.
It's not going to go like that, though, because now you got your defense out there a lot longer than what you would.
Yeah. He's still going, hold on, you make it seem like Tom Brady putting up Mahomes.
I'm not.
Or Russell Wilson. Or Aaron Rodgers type number.
I'm not saying that he doesn't have issues here and there. But at the end of the day, 300 wins, it's more about the players. And you want to give it either Tom or Bill, I have to give it to Tom because Tom is a player.
I'm giving it to Coach. Coach!
No way. Come on.
So, at the end of New England's victory yesterday, I tweeted this sentence. Congratulations to Tom Brady on Bill Belichick's 300th win.
Hater.
Because that just sums it up to me.
You hater. That's what it sums up.
The straight hate comes from across the table about Tom Brady. I've never seen or heard anything quite like it. because I have always given Tom 75% of the credit. If you want to lump players in there, it's a player's game. Mm-hmm. But in the end, it's a quarterback's game. And what did this man tell us about the leadership of Tom Brady? Because you told me late in that year when you were picked up by New England, you went in that locker room a little skeptical because you're a truth teller, man. You want to see it to believe it. And you went in there just looking to say, is he for real? Has he got a little phony in him? Is he behind closed doors the same guy he appears to be on camera? Mm-hmm. And you found that...
He was the guy that you see day in and day out. I know you hate it. Listen, I know you hate it because you just hate the Patriots. You hate them winning. I'm all for the old guy winning, you know what I'm saying? But like I said, I sat back, and you know how you sit back, you watch somebody move, you want to see how they interact with, you know, just the regular person, how they interact with the guy that's, you know, at their level. And he is that guy, dude. He is a truly, genuinely, like, good person, man.
Skip, this is not what this is about. This is not about whether he's a good person. This is not whether or not he should be anointed for sainthood. This is about who is most responsible for 300 wins. And it's hard for me to believe that the guy that brought everybody... So I just want to name the other player that Tom Brady has brought to New England. I just want to know... Hold on, I just want to know the coach.
I don't need to name the players.
Dozens of players came to want to play with Tom Brady. I mean, I could probably name 50 players who said, you know, if I got a choice, I want to play with that guy.
Coach Belichick, take these guys. All I know is Jamie Collins. What do the guys do when they leave Coach Belichick's defense? Other than Richard Seymour. Mm. You had to be like an all-time great player. Ty Law's in the Hall of Fame.
And so they're going with a different coach that probably don't know how to use them appropriately.
Mm. Oh, so now how to use them appropriately. So that's on the coach. So it don't matter what the player is.
If the coach still has to play, though.
But if the coach don't use you appropriately, how can you play if you're not in a situation?
So how are you going to get 75% to the coach if you're saying the player has to play? It has to be 50-50. Give it 50-50. Be honest.
No.
Give it yes.
Coach
Stop Be- it.
Because
Stop
Coach
it.
Belichick brings Hater. All this thing together.
Hater.
He brings the coaches, and he puts the players in situations in which they can succeed.
So, Shannon Sharpe, riddle me this.
Okay, let me try.
Bill Belichick's first 5 seasons of head coaching were with the Cleveland Browns.
Yes. Mm-hmm.
And they had 4 losing seasons because they had various Vinny Testaverdes and Bernie Kosars at quarterback, aging quarterback.
Yes.
And they just couldn't get over the hump. And he got fired. Yeah. And he comes to New England, and he's got Drew Bledsoe at quarterback. Mm-hmm. And he goes 5-11 the first year. And they start off 0-2 the second year. And one assistant on that staff said, we were all thinking about putting our houses up for sale because we thought we were on the way out.
Right.
And a player that Bill did not actually choose in the draft, I mean, it wasn't his idea to draft Tom Brady, took him in the 6th round, kept him on the team. I give him credit for that because he kept him as the 4th quarterback the first year and
Which
the second year.
Of.
And you start seeing him in practice and you start saying, wait a second, maybe we have something.
Right.
And he had elevated him to backup and he gets thrown into that game in which Drew Bledsoe got hurt and the rest is NFL history.
Right.
Right?
Right. And the guy that's made NFL history through 1 touchdown in all the playoffs. Hmm. He threw 1 touchdown. So how great was Coach Belichick's defense?
Hmm. Well, it was really good that year, but Tom Brady led the game-winning drive in the Super Bowl as the first
Skip, you're starter. Talking about a drive.
It's hard, man.
What good is the game-winning?
He completed 5 straight passes under pressure as a hopeless underdog.
The guy held a team that had 4 Hall of Famers on the offensive side of the football to 17 points. Mm. That's what that defense did. That defense last year in the Super Bowl, Tom Brady had a 26 QBR, held the second highest scoring team in the NFL to 3 points.
If you want to go to individual games, he's more responsible for this game than he is that game. True statement. But for 300 total altogether, what is it, 236 or something like that together?
Mm. It's crazy.
Come on.
And Bill, I trust.
Yeah. Well, I used to trust Bill
and Bill,
until this guy witnessed firsthand. Nick Foles put up 41 on Bill Belichick in a Super Bowl.
But see, there's my point. See, now you make my point for me. Mm. Because when Coach Belichick's defense don't stand on their head, like Hossick or Patrick Roy in the Stanley Cup, what happens?
Tom Brady throws for 505, the all-time record in a playoff game.
And his defense didn't stand on his head. Yeah. What happened?
We couldn't make 1 stop, man. All we needed was make 1 stop, man.
And what happened when Tom Brady led another game-winning drive against Eli in the first Super Bowl? Belichick's defense allowed Eli to come back and go 82
yards. You average
37
points, James. You can't get me but 14.
Wait a second.
James, you average 37.
Yeah, I got
the
goal all time.
Wait. The GOAT coach gave up an 82-yard 13-play drive to Eli Manning and lost the game. game 17-14.
Hold on. Michael Jordan. If Michael Jordan in a game 7 gives you, now he's been averaging 35 points in the playoffs, a career 30-point night guy, and all of a sudden he give you 15 and they lose, what you going to say?
Michael Jordan never needed a game 7.
I'm just saying, Skip Bayless.
He never needed a game 7.
Guess what?
Not once.
Coach Belichick says, you know what? I gave up 41 points, but Tom, if you don't turn it over, guess what? We win.
Listen, there's no way you're supposed to give up that many points in any game. I don't care where it is.
Tom Brady dropped that touchdown. What about that touchdown he dropped?
That wouldn't have been a touchdown.
That would
have been a first down. That would have been a first down.
That's all you got?
Just Shannon,
you've lost
300 wins, Shannon.
Coach Belichick got 300.
You probably got 30 games you can point out.
Coach Belichick got 276 of them. Mm-hmm. I get Tom Brady 24. Wow.
All right, I want to quickly say we did a little research, and you had a touchdown in that game
in
2002.
Yeah,
so
I got him.
There you go.
Got him.
You always have that one.
You know what? That disqualifies Tom Brady.
The whole
He's
thing?
Out.
If he had the touchdown.
He might be, what were you, third ballot Hall of Famer? So will Tom Brady because he lost to a third ballot Hall of Famer.
And I got a pass interference on Tabucky Jones on a goal route that axed the game.
Remember everything. Your memory is incredible.
Oh, look at Tabucky. I took it deep.
Who drafted him, I wonder.
Thank you for watching. You can subscribe here to get the latest from the show. And be sure to check out more of the best clips from Undisputed or go watch a few other segments from our other shows on FS1.